So as this worldwide pandemic unfolds, Americans have not been served well at all. How many times have I said for the last 3.5 years, so-called journalists, I call them the media mob. They think in one voice, and that is an extension, basically the party apparatus, the propaganda wing of the Democratic Radical Socialist Party. It's sad. They've been hurting the country for 3 years, and they continue this rage against Donald Trump, never ending. It's obsessive. It's compulsive. They're inaccurate reporting. Never been worse than it is now. Their partisanship never worse. It's a national disgrace. It's having real consequences. It hurts the country. They don't seem to care. Let's look at a timeline. For example, 3 days before President Trump declared a public health emergency and announced a China travel ban and implemented mandatory quarantines, we can go right to the usuals, the people that hate Sean Hannity and Fox. They were there getting it wrong as usual. BuzzFeed, an article, don't worry about the coronavirus, worry about the flu. January 31st, same day as the public health emergency, Vox tweeting, is this going to be a deadly pandemic? No, wrong. Also, January 31st, Washington Post, that would be Eric Pop the Pimples newspaper, publishing a piece with the headline, How Our Brains Make Coronavirus Seem Scarier Than It Is. Same day, fake news, CNN accusing the president of using coronavirus to spread fear, racism, and xenophobia, pretty much echoing all of the comments of the ever so confused presumptive Democratic nominee Joe Biden, February 3rd. Let's stay with the Washington Post. Why we should be wary of an aggressive government response to coronavirus. February 5th, New York Times. Yeah, that same New York Times that doesn't like me. A piece. Who says it's not safe to travel to China? Okay, that was a dumb idea. The coronavirus travel ban is unjust and doesn't work anyway. Great advice for the American people. Let's go to the Daily Beast. No fans of mine either, or conservatives. Coronavirus with zero American fatalities is dominating headlines while the flu is the real threat. And we can go to March 4th. Fake news, CNN telling their viewers to be more concerned about the flu than coronavirus. I think that was Anderson Cooper, their lead guy. 2 days earlier, it was Andrew Cuomo, the governor of New York, saying, oh, this isn't going to happen to us. You know, we're New Yorkers. We're New York. New Yorkers are tough. We have a much better health system. Turned out he prepared for nothing. Without a doubt, in the first critical months of this virus, the media mob accused the president of overreacting at worst. And I'll even say early on, it's understandable considering we were all being lied to by the Chinese government. But of course, the mob races to racism. President wasn't engaged, they say. Well, while they were impeaching him and the mob pushing the impeachment, while the president was implementing the travel ban that they were calling xenophobic, hysterical, racist, and fear-mongering. Well, the president acted sooner than anybody, 10 days after the first diagnosed case, known case of coronavirus in the country. Wow. How many more Americans might have contracted this disease? Tens of thousands. How many more might have died? How worse could this have been if the president didn't act that quickly with the ban, then subsequent bans and quarantines? Yeah, they were impeaching him. They were hating him at the same time, which they always do. They played down this disease over and over again. We're just beginning to touch the surface. Take a look.
People should be more concerned right now with the flu in this country.
A lot of people are concerned about the coronavirus because they're hearing a lot of news about it right now. But the reality is, comparing it to the flu, for example, it's not even close to being at that stage.
Sanjay, you were telling us the last hour that there's an important context we need to keep this in, and that is that the flu is more deadly.
Yeah, I mean, you know, this is one of the ironies, I think, that always comes up with this. Take a look at the numbers.
How worried should Americans be about coronavirus?
Coronavirus is not going to cause a major issue in the United States.
Half of the people in America do not get a flu shot, and the flu right now is far deadlier. So if you're freaked out at all about the coronavirus, you should be more concerned about the flu, and you can actually do something about it and get a flu shot.
I'm not blaming them. Facts changed all throughout this crisis, but they were wrong. The president on January 31st was right. They can't ever say, you know what, I didn't agree with it, but he was right. His travel ban, quarantines, aggressive action. Well, 10 days after the first known case in the country, it saved lives. How many, we'll never be able to calculate. Naturally, right on cue, the media mob, they shift their smear tactics. Suddenly, according to the mob, instead of overreacting, the president was actually underreacting. Now he's overreacting. They can't make up their mind. February 26th, the Times ran another unhinged op-ed. Let's call it Trump virus. If you're feeling awful, you know who to blame. March 8th, fake news, CNN. Let's call the Trump virus Trump's Katrina. March 9th, Washington Post. That would be Eric Pop the Pimples newspaper. Oh, it's Trump's Chernobyl. March 13th, the nation claiming Republican xenophobia is going to make this pandemic much worse. And just this week over there at MSDNC, one of their so-called genius conspiracy theorists saying tens of thousands of people will die because of Trump's coronavirus incompetence. Okay, make it up as you go along. Forget facts, forget truth, forget that there is a nationwide emergency. The media has been, continues to be, obsessed with using anything to bludgeon President Trump politically. We do have an election in 208 days. Don't think that's not playing a part in what they're thinking and how they're talking and what they feel.